Hello, I am Dr. Jayakrishnan, coming from Trivandrum, Kerala, which is the southernmost part of India. I am here to talk to you regarding the female factors for infertility. Among the female factors for infertility, PCOS and endometriosis are the leading causes of female factor infertility. And to talk about endometriosis, I'll have to go in detail. Endometriosis accounts for nearly 30-35% of female factor infertility, and it's a most common condition which we see in day-to-day practice. Not only affects the infertile couple, but it also affects the younger age group persons as well as and also the people in the reproductive age group. Now coming to the symptoms of endometriosis, it could be pain during menses. Normally the female experiences pain during the periods, which is known as a spasmodic type of dysmenorrhea. This occurs only during the first 2 days of periods. But the pain of endometriosis is known as congestive dysmenorrhea. That means that it starts couple of days before the periods, aggravates at the onset of periods and continue till the mid-cycle. And the second part of menstrual irregularity is a menstrual bleeding which may occur intermittently. And along with congestive dysmenorrhea, intermenstrual bleeding, she may have dyspareunia or painful coitus during contact. And apart from that, if the cysts are large in size, sometimes she feels some masses in the abdomen, for which she undergoes a routine ultrasound scan and endometriosis is diagnosed. Endometriosis can be diagnosed clinically, but more often it is diagnosed by ultrasound, MRI and other imaging modalities. Whenever we tell the patient that you are having endometriosis, the first question the patient asks us, what is endometriosis? Endometriosis is the presence of endometrium outside the inner lining of the endometrial cavity. Sometimes it is seen in the ovary, sometimes inside the ovary, and sometimes surrounding the uterus and pelvis, and forms cyst adhesions and pain during periods. So this is a very terrible problem, not only for infertile people, but also for the in patients in the reproductive age group, which actually mimics malignancy, because long periods of absenteeism is one of the most common features seen in patients with endometriosis. The basic treatment options available for patient with endometriosis is a clinical examination by a gynecologist, and the gynecologist suspects that the lady is having endometriosis by doing a pervaginal examination. The uterus is retroverted, fixed, and the cysts are usually palpable on clinical examination. Often sometimes endometriosis is missed by clinical examination, so if the gynecologist is in doubt, she refers for an ultrasound evaluation. Ultrasound evaluation tells you cyst in the ovaries alone, and deposits outside the peritoneal cavity in the tubes are not recognized in the ultrasound. And for sophisticated investigations, we go in for an MRI. MRI tells you whether the infiltration has occurred outside the uterus, whether the intestines, the ovaries, as well as the ureters are involved in these adhesions. So these are the sophisticated investigations usually done when you suspect it as a case of endometriosis. Now coming to the treatment part, normally when we diagnose endometriosis, minimal and mild endometriosis, usually we give analgesics, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents, and usually pain subsides. But if the patient complains of pain for more than 6 months and not relieved with analgesics, we go for sophisticated investigations like laparoscopy. Laparoscopy is putting a small telescope inside the abdominal cavity and looking at the endometriotic deposit. It helps to diagnose the endometriosis, as well as you can treat endometriosis by laparoscopy. And the cyst can be removed. The cyst which are supposed in the ovary are called endometriotic cyst. And the deposits outside the uterus is known as endometriotic lesions. So the endometriotic lesions are usually ablated or cauterized, and the cyst, if it's larger than 2 centimeters, are usually excised, and a complete recovery can be expected. But the only problem of endometriosis is the recurrence rate. 20-25% of these patients do come back with signs and symptoms of recurrence. How does endometriosis affect fertility? Minimal and mild endometriosis doesn't affect fertility, but when you do a laparoscopic evaluation and you find minimal or mild endometriosis, we just ablate the endometriotic lesions and the patient can have a natural conception. Whereas moderate and severe degree of endometriosis, where you find that the tube and the ovary and the surrounding structures are adherent, needs release of the adhesions, release of the cyst wall and ablation of the endometriotic deposits. Normally, after laparoscopic surgery, we expect around 30-40% of the people to conceive. But sometimes we find that even after waiting for 6 months, these people do not conceive. Then we may have to move on to the assisted reproductive techniques. The assisted reproductive techniques which we follow in moderate and severe degree of endometriosis is usually IVF. IVF is test tube baby procedure done outside. By taking the eggs outside and the sperm outside, and the fertilization is done in the lab and the embryo is transferred on the third day. And you find that assisted reproductive techniques may form one of the basic requirement to fulfill the needs of an infertile couple, especially when it has progressed to moderate and severe degree of endometriosis in more than 35-40% of the couples suffering from moderate or severe degree endometriosis. So if you are suffering from symptoms and signs of endometriosis, you have to meet a local doctor who will help you to diagnose endometriosis. And in case you are suffering from endometriosis and infertility, you have to meet the local expert or the IVF specialist to fulfill your dreams to have the two pink lines. Thank you very much.